Hey guys, and welcome to From the Shelf, and today we're talking about Ghost Rider. Ghost Rider is directed by Mark Steven Johnson and stars Nicolas Cage, Eva Mendes, Peter Fonda, Sam Elliott, and Wes Bentley. At the beginning of the film, we meet a young Johnny Blaze, played by Matt Long, who actually looks like a love child between Rob Lowe and Josh Duhamel rather than Nicolas Cage. He, along with his father, are a duo of stunt motorcycle riders for a traveling carnival. But unfortunately, sad events occur, and that's where our story begins. Time to embrace the cage. How is Nicolas Cage as Johnny Blaze? I'll be honest with you guys, I'm slightly biased towards Nicolas Cage. But in all seriousness, Cage is a comic nerd through and through. His stage name, Cage, comes from one of his favorite Marvel characters, Luke Cage. He named one of his sons Kal-El, and most comic book fans know that that's Superman's Kryptonian birth name. And he even has a Ghost Rider tattoo that they had to cover up with makeup for him even to be able to play Johnny Blaze. The flaming skull used in this film is even a digital replica of Cage's own skull. Cage makes this film in a lot of ways. From his comedic timing, ability to do his own stunts, and even going beyond acting by writing some of the script. You can tell that he really loves the character and wanted the best outcome with his work. So how's the acting? It's pretty bad, guys. The relationship with Johnny and Eva Mendes' character Roxanne brings awkward comedy, but the dialogue. Dialogue. Woo! The dialogue comes off as cheesy, especially when it's delivered by the film's villain, Blackheart, played by Wes Bentley. But most of that is due to personal issues in Bentley's life that I will respectfully not mention on camera. Fortunately for us, there is a silver lining here. Other factors help make up for the unfortunate weak villain, and they come in the form of Sam Elliott. Every time I saw his character of the caretaker appear on screen, I couldn't help but be drawn into the story.
How you doing over there, kid?
Let's talk about Peter Fonda's character, Mephisto, who I'm actually really disappointed isn't the main villain of the film, because he's one of the coolest parts about this movie. I really felt that this film suffered because of his lack of screen time. Whether it was a money thing or even the script, I felt like having him on the screen longer would have helped. Even if that was showing him in the underworld, monologuing, watching the events unfold. Let's change things up a little bit, shall we? The events of the first act show him as the villain. Let's keep it that way. Mephisto wants the contract of San Venganza that was robbed from him years before. Okay, fine. But here's where things change. Instead of having Blackheart just appear, let's amplify his motives that were already there. If we set the story up that Mephisto sent Blackheart and his gang to go find Ghost Rider and the contract and destroy him, then bring the contract back to Mephisto, that gives us time to see shenanigans occur with Blackheart stealing the contract for himself, thus making him a stronger villain, or something like that. Now, I know Mark Steven Johnson has directed some people's least favorite superhero films, like Daredevil, Elektra, Ghost Rider. I know this isn't official, it could just be me, but I feel like Johnson was inspired by Sam Raimi for this film. Once I turned that key and opened that door, it showed me a lot of style and subtle humor that I didn't notice before. To me, this film felt like a supernatural version of The Quick and the Dead with Sam Raimi-style close-ups and deadpan acting. In the end, I'm gonna have to give this one a meh. Maybe borrow it from a friend. Now guys, a lot of heart went into this film, but drive and a couple cool characters couldn't get this one to a metal claw for me. So that's been it guys, that's been my review of Ghost Rider. What'd you think? Let me know down in the comments down below. I hope you guys stick around for my next From the Shelf video, which will be Sam Raimi's Evil Dead. Groovy. Like, share, subscribe, like I said, comment down below. Let me know what you thought of this video. As always, guys, check out my Facebook group, Bluetooth Videos. There's a lot of cool guys on there. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram because you know I have them. But most importantly, guys, this has been Zach versus the Blu-ray Mountain. Stay metal, my friends.